Let's see. So let's say let's do it from a departmental overhead rate, allocate overhead to cost of products using the departmental rate. So if we, instead of doing the plant wide, just one rate, let's say we do two rates. We'll say overhead cost is 4.8 million, but we're gonna say 4.2 million is assigned to the machine department and 600,000 is assigned to the assembly department. And then we'll allocate these to each product. So, right, again, not complex. First one, we're just using one simple rate. Second one, we're saying maybe one rate isn't the best. Maybe we can use two rates. And so then here, we're gonna say that the assembly department, we're still gonna do it by direct labor hours for the assembly department. And the machine department, we're gonna say machine hours is probably a better indicator because we use less labor. And so then we decide, well, there's 70,000 of machine hours and 30,000 of direct labor hours. The machine hours is associated with the machine department, 30,000 for the assembly department. And we just determine our costs. So a lot of slides here, but the calculations should be very simple. It's just, what was our total estimated cost divided by our total machine hours? I'll say it's $60 per machine hour, $20 per direct labor hour. Take in mind, this is the exact same example as the first example. We're just allocating that 4.8 million in a different way. Instead of all doing it by direct labor hours across the whole factory, now we're just doing it by splitting it into two departments, and then we have machine hours and direct labor hours, but it's still the same 4.8 million. And so we'll get a different assessment, a different cost conclusion here that will probably be more accurate of what the products cost. And why do we care? Well, because again, we want to make a profit on our goods and we want to make sure that we're accurately trying to determine the costs of each go-kart so we can charge an appropriate margin and make profit or determine if it's not profitable. And so here we just do 4.2 million divided by the 70,000. We figure out a 60, we figure out a 20. And then we just apply it. We know it takes how many hours per unit for a standard go-kart and a custom go-kart machine hours. We'll have to trace it by machine hours from machining department and assembly department. And then we'll figure out our overhead allocated for the custom go-kart versus the department. And so we can see here that the standard go-kart under the departmental method gets less of an allocation and the custom go-kart gets more of an allocation. And that makes sense that the custom go-kart probably is using more costs because they're using more machine hours here. And so what are the advantages and disadvantages of all this information? Well, the advantages of a plant-wide overhead rate is it's simple. That's easy. It's easy to implement. We just say, we know the total budgeted cost for overhead. We know the hours worked or the machine hours, and we can easily apply it. What's a disadvantage? It's gonna be overly simplified. So it's easy to apply, and it's in a lot consistent with GAAP for external financial reporting. The advantage, it's too easy, and it may not really have a relationship. Like if a custom go-kart didn't use any hours, direct labor hours, we wouldn't really be doing a fair allocation. So it's not gonna be as accurate for management reporting purposes. The advantage of the department is we're gonna get more accurate overhead allocations. It'll be a more refined process, but we are making a lot of assumptions by department. And as soon as that we are making a great estimate on the different costs of overhead for each department. And if we don't make those estimates correctly, if we aren't sophisticated enough or make wrong assumptions, then we can really, really mess up our allocation worse than the previous. So we need a more sophisticated team. So these are the two simplest methods. We have the department method and the overhead, the plant-wide overhead rate method. And then activity-based costing is the most complex method, which we're going to go into next, but I'll stop for questions now.